There we go.
Hi.
So I guess now I can hand over to Hugo and Reno. They can introduce themselves, and then they can start the presentation on Next.js support for Slice Machine.
Okay. Do we wait for like 2 or 3 minutes if there is more people joining? I don't know if how many we were like on the previous session. So.
It looks like most people have switched over, but I guess, yeah, if you give them a second and if you start just introducing yourselves and then and then from there, hopefully everyone's in.
You good? You want to start introducing yourself?
I want to start introducing myself. My name is Hugo and I'm part of the developer team. So we've been working with Slice Machine for several months. Previously, we were working with Next and now we are porting the Slice Machine to Next.
Yep. And I'm Reno. I'm a product manager at Prismic. Same. I worked with Hugo and the team on Slice Machine. Our goal is like to improve the developer experience when you are building websites with components. That's why we created this product, because we had more and more people trying to use Prismic with different tech stack, mostly component based framework like React or Vue. And so we saw an opportunity to improve this process, and that's why we created Slice Machine. You will see us, I think, in other conferences presenting that. We did the first presentation, I think it was a month ago, introducing the product, and we try to communicate and release new elements to Slice Machine pretty often. And we jumped on the opportunity of supporting Next just after Next as Hugo told you, and so today we'll present that. Basically, we'll present the concept of Slice Machine in the context of Next JS and how we think this can help you build project with Next and Prismic, but also with Next at least websites with Next in the future. Cool. Alors, I need to share my screen now, I think, to present you everything. So, iPad is here. Okay. Can you see my screen, Hugo?
Sorry?
Can you see my screen?
I can.
Cool. Okay, so... for the sake of this demo, I created a simple Next app, just run create Next app and the first app that I will maybe launch just to show you quickly this. And so you have a simple Next app that is running, and what I will do is that I will launch a command that is called Prismic SM, SM for Slice Machine, that is the project that we just released, setup.
So basically, setup is the bootstrapper command.
Exactly. Exactly. It's like when you want to start a Slice Machine project with any technology, we just launch this command that will do different things. The first thing is that it will ask you to create at least to name a new Prismic repository that I will call the person demo. And
hi, he's asking if you can zoom a bit.
I can zoom, of course. And what you will do on top of creating a Prismic repository, it will download different dependencies, different packages, and configure basically my next project to be linked to my Prismic repository that I just created.
I will now... I'm going to interrupt you once again.
Yes,
Kevin is asking what's Slice Machine exactly. Maybe you can introduce what are slices,
yes,
and how we use them with Prismic.
Yes, that's true. So what is Slice Machine? Slice Machine, it's a set of tools that allows developers to basically build faster websites with components. So if I describe it like in concrete element, it's one, a CLI command that will help you bootstrap your project and help you in your process your workflow of creating new components for your website. A set of open source website sections, components. Currently, we call these slices in Prismic. We have a concept of a modular block of content that you can add, that we call slices, that help you to define website section that you can mix and match to create your pages. And so
slices are component data.
Yes.
Data components, sorry. Yeah. And the slice machine helps you build data components.
Yeah. And maybe this will become a bit more concrete while looking at the project. So by launching this command, the Prismic SM setup command just added some files into my project and some configuration, and also created a Prismic repository. So what I will do now, just to show you quickly what it did, is that I will create a new file in my pages. JD.json that will help me to generate dynamic pages. Just copy paste some code. So I imported some library that we added with the setup command. I imported a component, central component that we'll talk about, that is the slice zone. And I just created a simple page with this component, the slice zone, and fetch some data from Prismic.
Yeah, so basically Shu taught us about the guest static props, and here we are not using it, actually. We're relying on the own guest static props from the slice zone. So when you use get static props, it actually returns a get static props and does the query for you, etc.
So I will just go on a page, and I will see my slice zone providing me an empty state, or not. Maybe I will have to refresh my next server. Well, the demo effect, I will pass it. Okay, so I launched again my server. I have an error. No? No, okay, that's okay. I have my slice zone that is saying that it's empty and that...
Did you get scared? Did you get scared?
A bit.
Me too, actually.
That tells me that to render some component in here, I can go to my Prismic repository directly. So I will go to my Prismic repository directly by opening my dashboard. And opening the Vercel Meetup demo. I will create a first page. So in that case, as you can see, I have a set of components. So those are slices that I can use right now and that are pre-configured. So for example, if I choose this FAQ component.
So just to make it clear, when you run the setup command, so it created a custom type called page on our side. So custom type being like a data model, database model. And so now we have created a first page. Because on Prismic, you define the page as a repeatable custom type. We will be able to use its UID and map it to your page on your next app.
So I used just a simple component that is the FAQ component, and I published my document. And so now for this page, hello.
Kevin, I think I will go over how it happens at the end, because that's a good question.
I when I just enter this FAQ component, now you can see that in my page, there is this component that is rendered. This component, this component is coming from an open source set of components that we developed in partnership with an agency. Those are accessible, responsive components that are, like I said, open source, and that we provide at the beginning of the project when you use this Prismic SM setup. Yes, go ahead, maybe, if you want to answer your question.
Actually, you just answered Martin, who asked about the predefined slices components. Yeah. So with the setup command, you have like a default argument, which is the library that you want to download. So here, it's essential slices. We will probably share the repo later. I can send you the storybook already.
So I just use a FAQ component, but I can use another one just to show you the idea of first those components, but also the idea of slices. So as you saw, I chose a FAQ component. And then I can choose another component that I would put after the first one. So for example, the customer logo in that case. So trusted. I would make some images just to showcase, to show the idea. Okay, maybe 4 is good. Save and publish. And so you can see that I have another component that will show exactly the company logo type of component that you can find in many landing pages for startup. So if you want to show the different clients that you have, we provided a component for that and a whole set of different components that Hugo, you shared on the chat maybe. Cool. So now, what do you do with those components? So first, you can customize it. You can customize it through different ways. We offer CSS variables, but also some theme option that I will show you right away. So we created, for example, an app.js, file in your project that will basically help you to customize the theme that is passed to the component. And so for that, like I said, we provided you some kind of a README that will help you have a view on how to customize those. So I will add a custom theme here, and I will pass it now to my theme provider. Will be really ugly, but showing you what you can do. So basically, in that case,
nice.
I just changed some primary color. I just changed the background of my slices. I changed the color of an eyebrow.
We can see the designer in you.
And so you can edit and customize those slices directly thanks to the theme property. I don't know if there is some questions at the moment. Who says the devs can design? Yeah, exactly. Could you explain the relationship between a custom component I will make and the slice zone idea?
I think it will come next in your demo.
Exactly. So in that case, I was just using predefined component. Now, if I want to create a custom one, so I think it will answer your question. We provide a new command. I will just maybe. Yep. That is SM, create slice.
So starting from here, it's really work in progress. I think it's a command that we introduced not too long ago, and like we're pushing updates basically every day.
Yep. So I just type this command that is asking me to give a name to my slice and then to select the custom type in which I want to put this slice. So in that case, I only have one, it's the page one. I will push that, and if I go back to my Prismic document, so I need to refresh, but if I go back to my Prismic document, I now have a new slice, that is my new slice template, but in my code, I also have, if I look in the slice, a folder with an index.js, so a bootstrap component, the model, and some mock data that I would be able to use. So if I use now the new slice, I will just say, hey, hello, everyone, I'm open. Save, publish. My new component. I might need to refresh to restart the server now. Yeah. Yep, I'm good. I will remove the theme also.
Yes, please.
It's hurting my eyes. So yes, I restarted and now I should have my new component that is here. Hello everyone, and showing the data. Okay.
Quite nice.
That's nice. Okay, that's the name of the repo. Yes. okay. So now, what can I do with that? So since I have the code, for example, of my template, and I have also access to the writing room, if I want to add a new field, let's say a description, I would go to the custom type builder for my new slice, add a rich text field that I will call description. And edit by adding, this is a nice description. Just edit my code. Under the description, now, right after the title. And that's it. And so you can now start to customize your own slices and your own component set, or at least create it, while also playing with the open source component that we provided at the beginning. Okay. So now what's interesting in that is that there is different things that I can do. I can create a different set of components. And what we provide on top of that is that we provide a way for you to create documentation, basically, for the component that you created. So I created only one in that case. Maybe I will create a second one, but the design might not help to understand the idea. So I will try. I will just do Prismic SM create slice. Second slice.
John, we don't rely on GraphQL for this, so it's a REST query that is made to the whole document, and then we pass the whole slice data.
Then my second slice, for example. So now I have two slices that I can play with that I created. We can imagine that I did an awesome component by adding images, video, nice design, a lot of stuff that are really cool. And I'm ready to now share some documentation with my team. So for that, we created a command that is Prismic SM at storybook that would basically generate for all the components that you created through Slice Machine, a documentation like the one that Hugo shared previously on Open. So I will just open this. Where is the event? Where is the doc? So this one. Basically, for your own Slice library, provide a documentation for all the slices that you created in your own project that you will be able to host and to give to, let's say, your marketing team so that they have a view of your design system, or to other developers with like to provide a proper documentation of all the components that you created in the project in order to reuse them in the future, generate an NPM package, whatever. Hop, so this is running. Perfect, on time. not exactly.
And this one is long too.
Okay. So you get the idea. It will generate a storybook with all the components that you will be able to use to document. So this is a project that we are still investing a lot in by creating new components to the library, to the essential library, so the one that you are seeing at the moment. that we also invest to open to other technologies, and that we will add also more features in the future in order to make the process of creating slices and all the workflow of creating proper components with their documentation even easier and faster.
Can you show the first slice?
Yes, again? Of course. I know it.
Okay.
Could you explain? No, I'm a bit too old to create a new one. Okay. And so I think we are good for the demo. So now we can take some questions, I would say. Alors, can we share documentation? You did it, right? No?
No, not the Notion page.
Okay, cool. So we'll share now a Notion page that is the README on how to use it, how to use Slice Machine with Next. This will be introduced soon in the Slice Machine .dev website, where you can find different things. So browse the component directly, as Hugo showed you. So a view on the set of components on the storybook. You can find currently the full process on how to use Slice Machine with Next, but the next process will come. And also, if you want to contribute to the project, ideas on how you can help us to build this product. So by creating components or by helping us implementing some features in the tool sets, meaning in the CLI, in the Slice Machine API, and to support new features for that. Another way to contribute is also to provide us your requests and your ideas so that we can improve the product. And since we will develop more and more the product in the future, also be part of a beta tester that can test proof of concept or bugged released before we release them to everyone.
So Kevin is asking about Slice Machine being something made for prototyping or quick drawings or something that you can use in production.
So at the moment, we don't have any use case in production. We feel that this can be done, and we think that we have a process that is already good enough so that you can create slices for your production website. We start to use it ourselves for our own project. Mm-hmm. Now the thing is that why do we think it's a good process is that we will improve the process even more. And so at the end, if you are able to create quickly new slices, new components, generate documentation, generate a whole set of tools around your component, yes, this will make your process of building production ready component way more easier than doing it by hand and creating your slice through the your slice model through the custom type builder and stuff like that.
So basically at least the back and forth between the editor and the code, which is sometimes a bit frustrating, is going to be
simpler.
To be simpler now.
Yes, and the fact, like I told you, to have a proper component with like the proper set of files defined, like having the model close to the component, meaning that you can version it in your GitHub project, so you can have a code that is already with the proper model versioned. The fact that, for example, we have some mocks at the generation of the component that is done, provide you some also tools to work properly, and to generate a nice library that you will be able, for example, to share in NPM, being publicly or privately, but that you will be able to reuse in different projects in the future. So yeah. The thought that this will just be no. Okay, so this is the question. Tac. Okay, so Slice Machine is a feature providing pre-configured. Yep. Where did you get that new data field for the description? Wouldn't you need to update your GraphQL query? Okay, so since we don't use GraphQL for this, so John, it's an answer to your question. We don't use GraphQL for this. We use the REST API, and so we basically get all data for a specific page. So all the data for a specific slice, and the slice zone, the component that we saw at the beginning of the presentation. So the component that is imported here and rendered here, we basically get the data of a page And then send the proper data to the proper component, so the proper slice data to the proper component. So in the context of my new slice, for example, here, I just have to access the slice data by doing slice primary description or slice primary title. I hope it makes sense. Who say devs can design? Could you explain the relationship between a custom component? Okay, so this we answered.
You can use another storybook than yours. Basically, what you would have to do is to make sure you define the path to your slices. So then there would be added to your stories.
Is it similar to something like StencilJS? Do you know StencilJS?
No, but I'm pretty sure it's not. Never heard of it.
Never heard of it?
No.
So we don't have an answer for is it similar for to something like StencilJS.
So let's say no. Okay. If you get asked the question, please say no.
Are we actually at the stage where we can statically generate the website with Next and Slice Machine?
Yes, we are just polishing or finishing the preview part, so to make the bridge with Shu's presentation. Other than that, yes, you can statically generate the website right away.
Great feature, I love Prismic, thank you. I wonder if Prismic will integrate a kind of auth service like Auth0 with that Prismic will be the perfect service. So this is not really planned for now to work on an auth service. I don't know if it will come at some point. We feel that there is like a lot of nice solutions out there like Auth0, the one that you mentioned to handle this. So this is not on our radar for the moment now. But thanks for the kind words and we'll try to be the perfect service anyway at the end.
Okay, I guess I'll hop back in because it looks like you did a good job of answering all of the questions. I guess if anyone has like a last opportunity maybe to either ask Reno and Hugo a question specific to Prismic or Slice Machine, or even Shu a question if maybe some questions about Next have come up from this presentation.
Thanks, Kevin. Thank you, everyone. Well, this is a question for you.
Yeah, a question Reno will love to answer.
Hey, so. yes. So, no, we are not at the moment, Shannon. So the question is, I will repeat it for everyone, is there any plan for Prismic iOS Android app? It's not in our plan for the moment, no. It might work in improving the interface at first to make it more, let's say, mobile friendly, but have an app at the moment is not something that we plan to have. Exactly. I will be a big fan of creating an app, an Android and iOS app, but we have a lot of work to, not lot of stuff to do.
Okay. I guess if no one has any more questions, just thank you again to Reno and Hugo and to Shu before. I think it were really interesting presentations. Oh, there we go. We got one more just before we get the chance.
Oh. I also shared my Twitter account. You never know.
Ah, you want follower?
So, share mine too.
So can you unit test the slice like any regular React component?
Yes.
Yes, of course.
These are regular components.
Yes. Those are classic components. The only maybe difference is the fact that that we generate it through the CLI and that's it, but that's a React component. Okay, so I'm the only one not throwing my Twitter handle. Renaud Bressan on Twitter.
So yeah, make sure to give each one of them a follow. And I'm also gonna do my my marketing job. And if you did enjoy this event, we're gonna be more organizing more virtual meetups and hopefully physical meetups in the future. as well as some webinars and other types of events. So I'm just put a form in the chat, and if you can enter your details in the form, you'll be kept up to date on all of the events that we're planning. So if you've enjoyed this one, hopefully we're going to have quite a few more in the future. So that's the best way to keep up to date. And I guess if not, I guess thank you to everyone for attending and for the questions. It seems like everyone seems to have enjoyed it and the feedback's been really good. And thank you one more time to Shu and Reno and Hugo.
Thank you. Thank you, Edward.
Yep. See everyone soon.
Bye-bye. See you.